My name is Jim Bell, and our firm name is the JF Bell Group, and we're located in the potato capital of the world, Idaho, Idaho Falls, Idaho.
All right, so is there a lot of farmland around you, I guess? I don't know.
We have a lot of potatoes, a lot of potatoes and grain and malt barley for Budweiser and Modelo.
Okay.
So those are big things.
Okay, there you go.
No free samples, but...
Well, let me ask you some questions, see if you can encourage others that are running their own firms. You ready?
Okay. Yep.
So what things are difficult right now in running your own firm, Jim?
Well, I think for me, philosophically, one of the big things is trying to balance my succession plan with what I want to do right now. I'm a little bit different than some of my tribal peeps in that been doing this a little bit longer, and so... You know, I'm on the kind of the downside of my career, and so on one hand, I'm trying to balance what makes sense financially, if you know what I mean, as far as an exit strategy, although I'm not going anywhere soon, but, you know, it's creeping up. And on the other hand, you know, I've got customers that I've dealt with for 30 years, and we got things that work, and it's like, why break it? Why change it? But on the other hand, it's like, my personality is to blow things up and do stuff different just because I want to blow things up and do things different. So that's kind of a struggle for me right now.
That would be a struggle. Very cool. So how would you encourage others that are running and growing their own firms? So what would you say to them?
Well, I think what I would say to them, first and foremost, is be your best customer. I think I had somebody tell me that, but it was like way into my career, and I wish I would have heard that up front. And I see us as kind of an incubator for our clients, and so if we can be successful in our own business, then we can transfer that knowledge on and expertise on to other clients. So be your best customer.
Wow. And so that has a lot to do with pricing effectively, making good money, so that you can at least tell your customers, hey, I know how to make money, right?
Oh, exactly, and managing people and the technology thing and resources and adapting to change and marketplaces and whatever. So
that's awesome. I've never heard that before. That's good stuff. So our third question is, so what do you think the future holds for your firm? I mean, how you thinking about retirement, but not anytime soon. What is the immediate future for you guys?
Well, we... over the course of our firm life, you know, it's been kind of like a roller coaster, you know. We get all gung-ho and we grow, and then it's like, oh, well, we're tired, and we take a break and roll back and downsize almost, downsize. And so, you know, now we're back in the growth stage. So I'm looking at growing and minimizing our service menus, becoming a little more focused. Again, back to the first question, you know, how do you find that balance on long-term financial stability for, you know, the years to come down the road and yet trying to do what you want to do now? I see us moving more from compliance and product-oriented to value-added stuff. And so, you know, I'm just so grateful that I stumbled across Thrival because, you know, you guys got a lot of energy and a lot of great ideas and you're not afraid to do it. I had a lot of those same things trapped inside me, you know, but it didn't fit. You know, I wasn't trained that way, and that's just not the way us bean counters are supposed to do stuff. So, you know, we're looking to grow and focus and become more value-added.
Cool. Very encouraging. So, just a practical question. How do you use technology to serve your customers?
Well, I'm kind of a gadget geek, and so we got closets and drawers full of all kinds of little things that pop out, you know, where's an Echo pen, or it doesn't matter, you know, we got stuff that we buy, so that's neat and never get around to using it. But we've been paperless for, I'd say, 7 years.
Wow.
And we do a lot of remote access and of course, paperless remote access portals. We have portal systems that we've been using for... maybe 5 years,
yeah.
And honestly, they kind of suck. we're not getting a lot of use out of them. Some people use them, but so we're in the process of updating that and making it more user friendly. But definitely moving towards cloud based technology and a lot of the things that we talk about in Yammer day in and day out. So
awesome. Well, Jim, that's the In the Trenches video cast, man, with Bell.com. Can't thank you enough for being with us.
Hey, thank you.
All right.
Talk to you soon. Bye.